A very good morning to all of you. Yesterday we discussed about trade receivables, and today we are going to begin our lecture with the basic accounting term trade payables. Trade payables, it refers to the amount payable for purchase of goods or services taken in the normal course of business. Trade payables is the sum of creditors and bills payable. It is exactly the opposite of trade receivables. There was amount receivable, however here it is amount payable. There it was the sum of debtors and bills receivable, here you are having sum of creditors and bills payable. Now what are creditors and bills payable? Creditors is a person or a firm from whom goods have been purchased or services have been taken on credit and payment has not been made. It is shown as a liability in balance sheet. Reason being what? You have to pay this amount in future. You have taken goods on credit, thus that person from whom you have taken becomes your creditor. Bills payable. Bills payable means a bill of exchange accepted by the person or enterprise, the amount of which will be payable on the specified day. Yesterday we discussed over here. Mr. Sam sold goods and draw a bill. Mrs. Reed accepted that bill. Now for Mr. Sam, that was bills receivable, and for Mrs. Reed, that bill becomes bills payable, because in future she will be paying that amount to Mr. Sam. Next example. Deepak purchased goods worth rupees 20,000 on credit from Nishi. Payment has not been made yet. Thus here Nishi becomes your creditor. Alright, moving on to the next term. Bad debts. Students, yesterday we discussed about trade receivables. There was some little kind of confusion which many of you may have come across. That, ma'am, what if debtor refuses to pay the amount? Then it is known as your bad debts. Bad debts is an amount irrecoverable from a debtor. Since it is a business loss, that's why it is debited to profit and loss account. Ma'am, why loss is debited, we will discuss this in another chapter. Alright, moving on to the next. Cost. Amount of expenditure incurred or chargeable to a specified product or activity. Very easy term. Any product cost, any activity cost, that is amount of expenditure which has been incurred or which is chargeable to that product associated. Next comes is our voucher. Very, very important basic accounting term on which our whole accounting, our whole transactions will depend. Voucher is a documentary evidence, that is a proof of a business transaction. Examples: cash memo, invoice or bill, receipt, debit or credit notes, etc., etc. On the basis of this, you get to know some transaction has been taken place. And on the basis of that transaction, we record the entries in our books of accounts, then classify it and summarize it in financial manner. See students, here you can see one debit voucher. Here you have cash memo, payment voucher. There are various similar kind of vouchers available through which business transactions are recorded. Next is your balance sheet. Balance sheet is a statement of financial position of an individual or enterprise at a given date, which exhibits or shows its assets, liabilities, capital, reserves and other account balances at the respective book values. To understand this, as we remember, we discussed about financial statements. Balance sheet is one of the most important balance financial statement. It indicates the financial position of an individual or enterprise at a particular given date. That is, let's say for example, 31st March 2020 or 31st March 2019, whatsoever. So your balance sheet will be indicating at this particular date, our assets are this, liabilities and capital are this, reserves and other account balances are this, at the respective book values. Book values we will be discussing over here. Now you can see over here the format of balance sheet. In your left side, assets is being recorded, and on the right side, liabilities are being recorded. Assets should always be equal to liabilities plus your capital. All right, moving on to the next. Debit credit, very very interesting, on the basis of which our whole accounting depends. As we discussed, our accounts is based on double entry system. Now what is that double entry? Each transaction has two effects. One is debit and the another one is credit. Now what debit represent? Debit is the left side of an account. An account is to be debited. If an account is to be debited, entry is posted to the debit side of an account. However, credit is the right side of an account. An account is to be credited if entry posted to the credit side of an account. Now you can see the name format over here. For example, we are having machinery. We have purchased machinery. In name of the account, machinery will be written. That is machinery account. All right. Now whatever another account, whether it has been debited or it has been credited, it will be recorded as per. For example, if it is supposed to be debited, it will be recorded on the left side. If the another account is supposed to be credited, it will be recorded on the right side. Date of the transaction written to be under date, under particulars, name of the other account. Apart from machinery, as we discussed, two accounts are affected. So one of them is machinery. The other account which is supposed to be affected will be recorded under debit side. Folio. Now this ledger folio or journal folio, I will come upon it. Amount of transaction. Next, credit side, date of the transaction, name of the other account, amount of the transaction. Students, if we are having machinery account and at one particular date we are writing it off over here as machinery account, so only at one time another account will be posted just for once. Means we cannot record one entry over debit side also as well as on credit side also. Clear? Now this ledger folio or journal folio, basically it will be representing page or reference number of subsidiary book where the entry was first recorded. Example, machinery was purchased on cash. So if you're recording cash account over here under name of the other account, then you will be writing the page number in this folio section. All right, moving on to the next. Book value, amount at which an item appears in the books of accounts. Very easy to understand. Book value represents any amount at which your item represents in your books of accounts. Next is your entry. When a transaction and event is recorded in the books of account, it is known as an entry. Any transaction or event which is of financial nature, when we are recording it in our books of account, that is, you remember we discussed about recording. When we're recording over here, then it becomes our entry. If you remember, we discussed that any entry to be recorded is done in journal. Now, as you can see in this picture, we have journal entry format, where one column represents date, another column represents account name and debit credit. One account is supposed to be debited, another account supposed to be credited. And below that, there is one description of the journal entry. We will do this journal and ledgers in chapter number 8 later on. but just for the description we are discussing it over here. Next is your proprietor. Proprietor is a person who makes the investment in the business, manages it and bears all the risks involved in the business. As we discussed the word capital, the basic accounting term capital denoted the amount invested by the owner of the business. Now that owner is the proprietor. In accountancy, or rather in our commerce, we use this terminology as proprietor. Alright, I suppose I'm clear with today's class. For any queries, for any further doubts, you can WhatsApp or you can respond in your personal, or rather in WhatsApp groups created by your class. Your notes and assignment will be uploaded on ERP. Kindly go through them and complete them. Stay safe, stay home, have a good day, class.